The sport of baseball is often referred to as America's favorite pastime. Having showcased players of great talent, the United States has become a powerhouse of professional baseball, the plateau the best players are expected to reach. Early accounts show Americans began playing baseball in the late 1700s. In the 1800s, the game began to take shape and form with the rise of associations. In the 1900s, American baseball fans enjoyed the likes of Cy Young, Ty Cobb, and Babe Ruth. But while these men were on their way to legendary careers, the game of baseball was having an impact not too far from the States. Baseball was already being played in Cuba in the 1860s. Men who studied in the United States and American sailors stationed in Cuban ports were able to spread the game throughout the island. On the island of Hispaniola, the Dominican Republic was also embracing their new obsession, which would eventually become the country's staple.
Vladimir Guerrero just destroys one. In the air, left field, and Pujols has given St. Louis the lead. A dramatic, towering three-run home run.
David Ortiz has seen that number today with three hits.
This could be four. There he goes. It's over. The Red Sox win, and they're moving ahead.
Great catch to Otto Diamond. Hard line shot. His left.
Historians believe the Dominican Republic was first introduced to the game of baseball in 1891. At the time, many Cubans migrated to the Dominican Republic due to internal war. In that era, there were two Cuban brothers, Ignacio and Ubaldo Alomar, who assembled two teams who would play each other. One was called Cauto, or the Cubans, and the other called Cervecería, or Brewers. Cuban, Dominican, North American, and German men who worked in the brewery participated in this event, and this is said to be how the game of baseball was born in the Dominican Republic. At the beginning of the 18th century, two amateur teams were gaining popularity, Osama and Nuevo Club. Los Tigres del Licey were formed shortly after to compete against the two other teams. The rise in interest would also contribute to the construction of Licey Park in 1914. During the United States' occupancy of the Dominican Republic in 1916, American soldiers would compete against the Dominicans. This kind of friendly competition paved the way for new teams to be formed. Teams like Los Muchachos, San Carlos, and Del Colite were organized and would later unite to form Los Leones del Escogido, or the Lions of the Chosen One. By the 1930s, teams from the Dominican Republic were already playing other Caribbean countries, as well as teams from North America. It even goes unmentioned in baseball history that before there were Dominicans in the major leagues, there were a handful of Dominicans in the Negro leagues, among them Pedro Alejandro San, Esteban Vargas, and Horacio Martinez. In 1936, the game reached new heights when the first Major League Baseball team visited the island. 12 years later, the Brooklyn Dodgers became the second North American team to play exhibition games in the Dominican Republic. The 1937 Dominican Baseball League Championship proved to be a success. Dictator Rafael Trujillo was able to recruit players like Satchel Paige and others from the Negro Leagues to join his team, Los Dragones. The best colored baseball players in all of America were playing in this championship. At that time, the best baseball was played in Cuba, United States, Puerto Rico, and some in Venezuela. But those players ended up coming over here. After winning the 1937 championship, professional baseball in the Dominican Republic would be replaced by amateur competitions until 1951. Sporting venues would be built throughout the 1940s. In 1948, the Dominican Republic would win the amateur baseball championship in Nicaragua, their first championship since entering competition in 1941. They would go on to win it all again in 1950, but this win proved to be more significant. Soon after returning home from Nicaragua, the players would form the National Federation of Professional Players, which would lead to the reinstatement of professional baseball in 1951. Better things would follow, beginning with the construction of Estadio Quisqueya in 1955. It was a brilliantly designed and well-built stadium for its time. With the stadium came lights and what is considered Dominican baseball's golden era. It would lead to the initiation of the country's professional baseball league. And I did say better things would follow, didn't I? In 1956, Osvaldo Virgil became the first Dominican-born player to sport a Major League Baseball uniform. The game did come to a minor halt between the 1960 and 1962 seasons due to political reasons. The Revolution of 1965 would also put the game on hold. In 1970, the Dominican Republic would strengthen its presence among Latin American countries when it entered the Caribbean Series. By this time, there were a handful of Dominican-born players in the major leagues. But this was only the beginning.
Batista,
Padre Rodriguez,
Robinson Cano, Nova,
Vladimir Guerrero.
For years, there has been a steady pipeline of baseball talent from the Dominican Republic to the major leagues. Every team is on the lookout for the next Dominican superstar.
Mm. Major League Baseball clubs are making dreams a reality for the Dominican Republic's youth. By building baseball academies all over the country, MLB organizations give teenagers as young as the age of 16 the opportunity to showcase and polish their skills on the diamond. Some believe that these organizations exploit their prospects. Others are upset with the percentage of prospects that actually move on to play minor league baseball in the United States.
El béisbol no es como mucha gente lo piensa. El béisbol tiene mucho esfuerzo, mucha dedicación. El béisbol hay que trabajar todos los días. Muchos conseguimos que nos firmen o conseguimos casi que nos firmen, pero de 100 que firman llegan 2. Today, there are more Dominicans playing in the majors than from any other country in Latin America. And the Dominican Republic has more players in the majors than all other countries in Latin America combined.